In this video, we are going to cover how we can run our Maestro end-to-end tests in our Expo React Native app. I have my project open right here in front of me. And yeah, if you want to also follow along, I will leave the project link down below so you can copy the starter branch and start from there with me. And before starting out, you need to make sure you have installed Maestro. If you haven't already, you can follow the instructions over here. And after doing that, you need to come to our project and we need to run npx expo prebuild. So what will this does is this will give us the native directories, the iOS and Android one. And after this gives us our native directories, we can if you wanna, you can edit the project native code over here. Same for iOS, you can run, you can open Xcode and edit from there. But we won't need to edit anything. After this finishes installing, we just need to run our project like we run in Expo Go, but it won't be running with Expo Go. Okay, so we need to right now run npm run Android. This will use the native directory, not the Expo Go one. So I'm just gonna cut over here because this is going to take a while because it's the first time. I will see you at the other end. As you can see, my project is done. It is finished. And from over here, you can see that it is using the development build that we made with prebuild. If you want to switch to Expo Go, you can do it by pressing S. We want to keep the development build. So here is my app. I just have a login page over here. Let me show you the app quickly. .com password. Sorry. Let me put. So it's just a job listing app. You have job details and job listings over here. Nothing complicated, just to test some stuff. So after this, we can actually run our Maestro test. This is pretty much it. And you have to have a YAML file. The name doesn't matter. You don't have to put it in a .maestro folder. I just put it like there. I like it. And you need to put your, if you are not following along, you are doing this in your own project, you need to change the app ID that the expo asked you in the first step. And if you forget it, you can find it from here. Bundle identifier for iOS and package for Android over here. And after running your test, after putting your test here, you can run your tests just like this pretty much. And yeah, login.yaml, yeah. And this will launch the app. You need to make sure you close the expo pop-up over here or else it will fail. So it's typing, yeah, I can see it. Yeah, I think that's it. It will check all the marks over here from now on. So this is the first way of doing this, and there's also actually a second way of doing it with Eas CLI. You can do it also with Eas CLI. It's Expo's cloud, or you can cloud build, or you can build in your local machine. We are going to check that out in the second part. Okay, so for the second part, we need to install a few things, two actually. We need to install, let's clear this. We need to install the Eas CLI. So it's npm install global Eas CLI. I'm not gonna run it, I already have it. If you haven't already, you need to install this globally. And after installing that, we also need to install npx expo install expo div client. I already have it installed too, but let me just run it. And after installing these two things, you are ready to start the second step. First, let us delete the old app from here that we made with prebuild. And after that, you need to have an expo.dev account. If you have, you can skip this step. If you haven't, you need to create an account. Then we come to our project and we need to run Eas login. Yes, you need to put your credentials here that you registered with, and that's pretty much it for this step. After this step, we can run our Eas build. configure, we need to configure it first, and you can do that by ESBuild configure. This will also ask some questions. Yes, I already have a project. I'm gonna configure it, and because I already tried it before, and I'm just gonna do Android. iOS takes a time, iOS takes a little time, so I'm just gonna do Android. So okay, it generates a ES.json file, and you can see these are actually the build profiles. We have a production, preview, and development profile. For this video, we are going to go with the development profile, and you can specify the profile tag. You will see just in a second. So now we can build our app with Eas CLI locally. So we are going to es.build.--profile. As you can see, I already run this command. Development, and I only want Android. You can also put here iOS if you want to run iOS. I will do Android for now, and I want this to run my local machine. Then I'm gonna start this. So this will also take a while, so I'm just gonna cut right in. So our build was successful, as you can see over here. And contrary to the first step, the pre-built one, this one takes a little while because it builds the whole app. And after the build is done, you can open another terminal, you don't need to. And you can run npx expo start --dev client. Keep in mind that we installed this library at the start of this step, the expo dev client. We installed it from npm, and after running this, we can just drag and drop our file over here to the emulator. And as you can see over here, I already deleted the old one, so this is the new one. Now I can open it, and the first time over here, you can see we have a server running, and this is this server. As you can see, it is the same old our project, and we can run our Maestro just like the first step, and this will also work the same way. Maestro, running Maestro doesn't change how you build the app changes pretty much for the steps. Other than that, the Maestro doesn't care about your app. It just needs to find the app ID on the emulator or on your device. That's pretty much sums it up. If you have made this far, thank you for watching. And if you have any questions about the video, leave them in the comments down below. And please don't forget to like and subscribe. It helps a ton. And I'll see you on the next one.